would you like me to write and talk about?
I would like you to say to those people that David Cook's not a quitter. He just needs people to pray for him. But before you leave me, let me tell you what it is we need to do to get to those people. You see, we can say that we're praying for them, and we can go out and we can do all those fancy old concerts and, you know, get all them old awards and everything, but who's out there? Who's those soldiers out there doing the work? It's so political out there. So you know what we got to do? We got to go out into those communities and we've got to wake the town and tell the people. We can't let them just sit back.
If you listen, you can hear your
And sometimes this is the best way to do it, get it out there with the people.
But David, what would you want the people to know right now?
I want them to know that they better get right. Because tomorrow they're going to come.
Amen.
And if tomorrow never comes, amen. And if tomorrow never comes, I need to walk on heaven and miss him. But you know what? More than anything else in this world, the people would want to do anything for me. When they went to pray, I'd want them to speak up. Just let them know that I love them. And let them know that I'm not going. But when they kneel to pray, just tell them. Yes, you do. Thank you.
I hope that you're enjoying David Cook as much as I am.
Yeah.
Let's all give him a big hand. Just in the couple months that I've known David, I've learned that he's very sincere about his work. And I really believe that he loves the Lord. And he can share a little story with me about the reason that he even got involved with the homeless. And the story was, he met a homeless man on the streets, and he was hungry. And he says, well, isn't the local shelter, doesn't it have some food that you can get? And he said, they ran out. And David has been going out all this past year, and his main thrust is to help keep pantries and food banks restocked, because he doesn't want to find another homeless person that can't even find a meal. I think that is something that we all need to do in more ways than one. There's many ways that we feed people. It's not just in food that we can physically give them. It's also the Word of God and it's the Spirit. And I think that that's the kind of message that he's sending here. And I really praise the Lord for that sincerity. Right now, I'd like for you to just think of it a minute on how the Lord can use you in that same way in your own community, with your own singles groups, with your own church. And I want you to think about how God has used you in that way this year. Now, we've given David a big hand. I would like to give the Lord a big hand. And let's pray through this for a few minutes. Let's just all give the Lord a little bit of praise by him. Just for you.
Thank you.
shame and such disgrace. On Mount Calvary, take my place. Then I ask myself a question, who am I?
That much involved here in Eastway, but he's become a very dear friend to me. I met him a couple of years ago, and I'll be honest with you, the first time I met him, we did not get along very well. that's mild, to be honest with you. But I prayed about him. I said, Lord, I want to learn to have that Christ-like love. And that means even the ones that I don't particularly care to be around. I shouldn't have prayed that.
Praise the Lord.
Well, my friend and I became very close, and now I call him my brother. He is an East Coast Bible College student, and he's currently getting ready to go to Russia, or actually to Czechoslovakia. And that's why they have their bees out there, not vegetable meal. They're trying to earn some money so they'll be able to go. And I would like to introduce him to you with all my love and all my appreciation. He's Mark Poole.
Right by trade.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Is everyone receiving a blessing tonight?
Amen.
You know, when you're in the ministry, the hardest thing to do is to battle. But when you set your heart on going into the ministry, doing the work for the Lord, understand that the wickedness and the